Hi everybody, welcome back. This is going to be part 3 of the homemade press brake build series. If you haven't watched part 1 or 2, then make sure to click on the link here in the upper right or check the video description. So before we jump back in, I just want to take a moment and just thank everybody who have purchased the build plans and the press brake well pack. This really means a lot to me. Doing so enables me to continue to do what I do and share stuff like this. If you have reached this far of the build series and are thinking about building one like this, make sure to check out my website, ratha.com, or click in the links in the video description for more information. All right, let's jump back into it. Now let's move on to the limit switches and how we add the glass scale to the Z or Z axis, pretty much the up and down. So here's my first mock-up of the limit switch. It works, but I wanted to refine it more to make it simple and easy to put together, especially for people that are going to build their own. But first, let's rip out the old design. I also eliminated the linear rail bearing guides seen in the first video. I felt like it was pretty redundant to have it. To make it easier to get the press brake tool into the frame with the bracket installed, I remade the limit switch into two pieces. Being two pieces also allows it to be adjusted with having the built-in slots. I then add two washers to be used as spacers so the encoder on the glass scale doesn't rub against the tube. Because the encoder will be traveling in the up and down direction, Z, it's important to make sure the glass scale is square with the bracket. Now it's time to reattach the limit switch. Luckily, I was able to reuse my existing mounting holes, but ideally, you would have to set the position of the limit switch to make sure that your max and min travel is met. First, you want to bring down the ram all the way down until it bottoms out on the largest V opening of the V block. Then thread the adjustment screw so that it's protruding about half inch below the coupler. Next, move your limit switch arm until you hear the click and align the wheel center so it's center with the screw and is touching it. This would be your ideal position for where to mount the limit switch. Next, rotate the V block to the smallest V opening and adjust the screw. Check to see if there's enough thread engagement. If so, then you have successfully set the upper and lower limits of your limit switch adjustment screw. This will make sure you don't bottom out the adjustment screw in either the min or max V opening. I hope that makes sense. And last, this is optional, but you can add a second limit switch if you like. This will help set your upper limit switch where the ram has to stop. And this may be useful when you add a auto retract, which I'm gonna try to do to this setup. Okay, let's do a demonstration of how we use a second glass scale to help us with bending parts. First, let's bring the ram back up to zero. With this press brake tool setup In general, the set bending depth is determined by these five factors: type of material, material thickness, width of material, bend angle, and V opening. I know, it's a lot. For this example, we're gonna use 1/8 inch, or I guess 11 gauge thick mild steel. And the width of material will be this. We're looking to do a 90 degree bend. And last, we are using a V opening of 22 millimeters. There's four sides to this. I believe there's a 50 millimeters, 16, 22, and 35. So for this part, I know the ram needs to travel down this distance to achieve the results. Now, let's say we go and bend a different part. I'll have to change the adjustment screw. Then let's say a week goes by and I need to bend this particular part again. I can now literally preset everything because I know where the adjustment screw has to be based off the DRO reading that we calculated prior. Now let's take this part and see if we can achieve the same results as before. So this is the advantage of having a glass scale in the Z direction. You can see we got really close. You know, we may had to turn it, tweak it here and there, but at least we have a general idea of where the Z reading needs to be for this particular part. And this way I don't have to like guess where the adjustment screw needs to be. I can now go off the previous recorded data. I also want to point out the Z depth would change per those five factors I mentioned. For example, if I wanted to bend the same 11 gauge sheet, but let's say this part was actually wider, let's say it was 12 inches, I'd have to make a slight adjustment to the adjustment screw to account for that width. It's gonna change every single time. And I think that has something to do with the bend deflection as you go wider in material. I hope that makes sense. And with all that, here are some examples of what I've bent up so far with this tool. We got a control box. I made this plasma stand. And I'm also bending some 5/16 parts as well. And if you're wondering how thick of material this press brake tool can bend, there's a lot of factors, but we're just gonna go off what we have right now. So I'm gonna use the largest V opening. I believe it's 50 millimeter opening. And we're gonna do a 3/16 thick part, full length, which is, I believe it's 610 millimeters or roughly 24 inches wide. So this is the result. It bent 3/16 thick plate across the entire bending width with no problem. And it looks to be uniform all the way across. Now let's push the press brake tool a little and see if we can get a tighter bend radius by bending the same plate with a smaller V opening of the 35 millimeters. It definitely seemed to make the machine work harder, but it seemed to bend just fine. Here is a quick clip at the upper frame deflection. Pretty cool to see. It did go back to normal and it's still squared. To better see how the parts were uniform, I took it and placed it on my welding table to see how flat it was against it. You can see there's no crowding effect in the part, which tells me it's bending uniform across the 24-inch width on 3/16 thick mild steel. And let's compare the two bend radiuses. You can see the smaller V opening will give you a tight inner bend radius. All right, overall, I'm just happy I got to bending with this entry level setup. It literally has unlocked more doors on how I form metal by bending. And now when I design any parts, I'm always thinking about how to incorporate bending so there's less post assembly work required. So essentially, if I want to make an L bracket, instead of cutting it into two pieces and welding it, I can just bend it now. It's just that much less work. And that about wraps it up for the press brake build. If I miss something or if you have a question, make sure to leave it in the comment section. I'll try to do my best to answer it. Anyways, if you found this video helpful, do me a favor and don't forget to smash that thumbs up button or hit that thank you button. And hit that subscribe button for DIY projects like this. That's it for me. Time to get back to it.